In this video, we are going to look into the summary of the play Electra, written by the Greek tragedy writer Euripides. The main characters of this play are Electra, daughter of Agamemnon, Orestes, her brother, Clymenestra, her mother, Aegisthus, lover of Clymenestra. The plot begins here. After Agamemnon, the king of Argos, had returned home from the Trojan War, his wife Clymenestra and her lover, Aegisthus, murdered him in cold blood during the homecoming banquet. After that, Aegisthus and Clymenestra were married and Aegisthus became the king. Orestes, who was the son of Agamemnon, was sent by a relative to Phocis before Aegisthus could destroy him. Electra, the daughter of Agamemnon, remained, but was given in marriage to an old peasant. They made sure that she will never marry a warrior who is powerful enough to avenge her father's death. One day, after Electra and the peasant had gone out to the day's work, Orestes came in disguise with his best friend Pylades to the farm to seek Electra. They heard her singing a lament for her lot and for the death of her father. A messenger interrupted her lament with word that a festival would be held in honor of the goddess Hera and that all Argive maidens were to attend. Electra said she preferred to remain on the farm away from the pitying eyes of the people of Argos. The messenger advised her to pay honor to the gods and to ask their help. Electra mistook Orestes and Pylades as friends of her brother and told them the story of her grief. She urged that Orestes avenge the death of Agamemnon and the ill treatment of himself and Electra. Aegisthus, meanwhile, had offered a reward for the death of Orestes. The peasant returned from his work and asked Orestes and Pylades to remain as his guest. Electra sent her husband to bring the relative who had taken Orestes away from Argos. On his way to the peasant's cottage, the old foster father noticed that a sacrifice had been made at the tomb of Agamemnon, and there were some red hairs on the grave. He suggested to Electra that Orestes might be in the vicinity, but Electra answered that there was no chance of his being in Argos. When Orestes came out of the cottage, the old man recognized a scar on his forehead. Thus brother and sister were made known to each other. At the advice of the old peasant, Orestes planned to attend a sacrificial feast over which Aegisthus would preside. Electra sent her husband to tell Clymenestra that she had given birth to a baby. Electra and Orestes invoked the aid of the gods in their venture to avenge the death of their father. Orestes and Pylades were hailed by Aegisthus as they passed him in his garden. The pair told Aegisthus that they were from Thessaly and were on their way to sacrifice to Zeus. Aegisthus informed them that he was preparing to sacrifice to the nymphs and invited them to tarry. At the sacrifice of a calf, Orestes plugged a cleaver into Aegisthus' back while Aegisthus was examining the entrails of the beast. Orestes then revealed his identity to the servants, who cheered the son of their former master. Orestes carried the corpse of Aegisthus back to the cottage where it was hidden after Electra had reviled it. At the sight of Clymenestra approaching the peasant's hut, Orestes had misgivings about the plan to murder her. He felt that matricide would bring the wrath of the gods upon his head. But Electra, determined to complete the revenge, reminded Orestes that an oracle had told him to destroy Aegisthus and Clymenestra. Clymenestra defended herself before Electra with the argument that Agamemnon had sacrificed Iphigenia, their child, as an offering before the Trojan venture, and that he had returned to Argos with Cassandra, princess of Troy, as his concubine. Electra indicted her mother on several counts and said that it was only just that she and Orestes murdered Clymenestra. The queen entered the hut to prepare a sacrifice for Electra's supposed firstborn. There she was killed by Orestes, who mourned in distress at the violence and bloodshed and matricide in which the gods had involved him. The Dioscuri, twin sons of Zeus and brothers of the half-divine Clymenestra, appeared to the brother and sister, who were overcome with mixed feelings of hate and love and pride and shame at what they had done. The twin gods questioned the wisdom of Apollo, whose oracle had advised this violent action. They decreed that Orestes should give Electra to Pylades in marriage, and that Orestes himself should be pursued by the Furies until he could face a trial in Athens, from which trial he would emerge a free man. This is all about the play. This play is a psychological study of a woman's all-consuming hatred for her mother and stepfather on the one hand, and love for her murdered father and exiled brother on the other. The character of Electra clearly dominates the action, for it is she who spurs her brother on to kill those whom she hates. That's all about this summary. Thank you for watching this video.